हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन इन फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स क्लास। लास्ट वीक आई कुड नॉट टेक एनी क्लास ड्यू टू सम पर्सनल एंगेजमेंट और सम पर्सनल इश्यूज, सो अगेन आई एम रिज्यूमिंग टुडे इन आवर क्लासेस। Sorry if you are having any inconvenient. So today we will start a new chapter and very interesting and very conceptual chapter. I will emphasize on the understanding the concept I will not emphasize that how to find out the work done, what is the way to find out work done by the jet on the turbine. I will emphasize first that what is the concept behind getting the force applied by a jet of water. And once we have known the force applied by jet, then easily we can find out the power applied by jet by multiplying the velocity of the turbine blade or plate, whatever. So first, today's class, you need to concentrate very much to understand the concept behind how to find out the force. What is the concept behind finding out force applied by jet? First, I will brief that what is the impact of jet and turbine. This chapter, I am combining both chapters here. Impact of jet and turbine, because these both chapters are interrelated chapters. Unnecessary two separate chapters are given in the syllabus, but I would like to combine here these two chapters. I am making it as single chapter, impact of jet and turbine, because there is no existence of turbine without impact of jet. So, what I will brief, first I would like to brief that, okay, from the outlet of a nozzle, the liquid comes out in the form of a jet. When come out in the form of jet? When nozzle is fitted to a pipe through which the liquid is flowing under pressure. Means when a nozzle is fitted at the end of a pipe, and water is flowing with pressure, full of pipe, with pressure in the pipe, then through the nozzle, the water will come out in the form of jet. Very high velocity water jet will come out from the nozzle. If in the path of that jet, if we place some plate or some ball that is some hemispherical shape of shape object, then the jet will exert a force on that, not on the plate, on ball. That is our requirement in this chapter. If simply if you will put your hand in the front of jet, you will exert a very high force. You can experience that if you are having a jet. So here our requirement is plate or ball. So I am telling that if a plate or ball shape thing is placed in the path of jet, the jet exerts a force on that ball or plate. The value of that force we can easily obtain. How? By the second law of Newton. By the help of second law of Newton. And what is that? What is that law of Newton? Second law of Newton. We are studying from class 7. That what is the second law of Newton? I think from class 9 we are studying. What is the second law of Newton? Force on a body is equal to rate of change of momentum. And what will be direction of force? Direction of change of momentum. The rate of change of momentum will be equal to force applied on the body. And the direction of force, what will be direction of force? The direction of change of momentum. This is the simply second law of the Newton. But here we have to apply this on the jet to find out the force applied by jet on the ball or plate. So here I have drawn a figure. This is hemispherical shape thing. You can say plate or ball. This is ball, hemispherical shape. And I am applying a jet tangentially to the inner surface of this ball. Suppose jet is entering air at this end. This is exactly tangential direction. So because ball is hemispherical, so the jet will enter here. Suppose the surface of jet is smooth, so without losing any energy, this jet will glide on the surface of ball and leave this ball at this end. Means this jet enter here in x positive direction and leave the ball in this direction, negative x direction. Because it is hemispherical, so it is exactly circular path and hemispherical path. So this is entering in x positive direction and coming out x negative direction. This we have taken a simple example just for the sake of understanding the concept to calculate the force applied by jet. Suppose first we will consider that force on the jet. Then force applied by jet will be just opposite to that. Because Newton's law tells that force on a body is equal to rate of change of momentum. So here body is this jet. So I would like to first calculate the force on the jet. Then because this jet is applying force on the ball, so that force will be equal and opposite to that force on the jet. Force applied on the ball will be equal and opposite to force applied on the jet. So first I would like to calculate the force on the jet. So what will be force on? Let Px be the force on the jet. And direction I will decide in x direction. In x direction, what is the force on the jet? So what will be the force on the jet on in x direction? Let Px be the force. And what will be, as per Newton's second law, rate of change of momentum of jet in x direction. In which direction you want to find out force? In same direction, if you are able to calculate the rate of change of momentum, means you are calculating the force on dead body. So here I want to calculate the force on the jet in x direction. So we will have to find out the rate of change of momentum in x direction. What is the meaning of momentum? Mass into velocity. And rate of change of momentum means in a particular time period, what is the rate of change of momentum? What is the change of rate of change of momentum with respect to time? That is the force, value of force, average force in that interval of time. So suppose we want to find out the force on the jet. Suppose jet is entering, suppose m mass of jet is entering at this end of the ball, and in t time that mass glide along this circular path without losing any energy and come out from this end. Let it take t times, m mass entering here, and in t time it's glide with same velocity because there is no loss. It is entering, the jet is entering tangential, so there is no loss of velocity, and this is our assumption, and this is also close to very true, and it is also our assumption that the surface of this ball is very smooth, frictionless surface. So with v velocity this jet is entering, let m mass is entering, and in t time that m mass is leaving this plate ball. So in t, this t time m mass is entering here and leaving here. So if we able to calculate the rate of change of momentum in t time, that will be the force applied on the jet during this period, and opposite to that force, whatever force is applied on the jet, opposite to that force will be the force applied on this ball by the jet. So first we will calculate the force applied on this jet during this t time period. T time period, what is the t time period? When jet is entering in this plate and jet is leaving this plate. This is the t time duration. Now let rate of change of momentum of jet, we want to find out the force in x direction on the jet. So rate of change of momentum of jet in x direction is equal to, this is a symbol of change, delta is a change of symbol change. So change of momentum as per Newton's second law, change of momentum divided by change of time taken. So the change of momentum divided by time duration, this rate of change of momentum will give us the force applied on the jet. So final momentum of the jet when jet is leaving this plate minus initial momentum of the jet when jet is entering this plate divided by time period. Let this time period when jet is entering and leaving this, that is delta t, is equal to t. So final momentum, let when jet is entering in this ball at this corner, let v1x in positive x direction be the velocity of the jet. When jet is leaving this, then say v2x in negative x direction be the velocity of the jet. Now final momentum is mv2x minus initial momentum is mv1x divided by time period t, and we take out mass common out, this factor will be common in both mass, so I am taking out this mass, so this will be mass into v2x minus v1x divided by t. So what is the m by t? Because this is jet, mass of one particular mass we have taken and t we have taken, then what will be m by t? n by t will be mass flow rate of this water, mass flow rate. And what will be mass flow rate? Volume flow rate into density. We know discharge, what is the discharge? Discharge is Q, and Q means discharge, means volume flow rate. If volume flow rate is multiplied by density, then it will give us mass flow rate. Means m by t will be Q into rho. That we will again discuss in later on, but I have just touched this because I have mentioned on the figure that m by t is equal to Q into rho. This is not the p, this is rho. Okay, so I am saying this figure 1, and fx is the force applied by jet on the this plate, and px is the force applied on the jet. So this will be minus, here will be minus. So here m by t is called mass strike rate. Remember one thing, remember m by t is the mass strike rate of the liquid on the plate or ball. This is the mass strike rate. This is, it is not the mass rate of mass coming out from this jet. This is the, what is the, whatever mass is striking on this plate, m by t is mass strike rate. But here mass strike rate and mass coming out from this jet is same because plate is fixed. So m by t is the mass strike rate of the liquid on the plate or ball, and px is equal to direction of measurement of the force on the jet. Px is equal to force on the jet in the x direction. We want to calculate the force in x direction, so I am writing here px. And what is the v1x? Velocity of the jet in direction of measurement of force during striking the plate. This is the measurement of direction of measurement of force. So v1x, let's say v1x is the velocity when jet is entering this ball in x direction, and v2x is the velocity of jet when jet is leaving this ball. So this is the final velocity minus initial velocity. So this equation, if we are knowing all the thing in this equation, we can find out the force applied by jet on the this ball or plate. Let us see some more important thing. So as I told that v2x is the velocity of jet in the direction of measurement of force during leaving the plate after striking. If fx is the force applied by the jet on the plate or ball, then it will be equal and opposite to the px, because the px is the force applied on the jet during the period when jet is entering and leaving the ball. So force applied by jet will be equal and opposite to px, so that is fx will be equal to minus px. And what we are getting? Px m by t bracket in bracket v2x minus v1x. So fx will be m by t v1x minus v2x. Fx is equal to force applied by jet in the plate, on the plate or ball. So what does this equation tell us? Force applied by jet on the plate, this will be, I am writing here in the in words, force applied, fx is equal to force applied by jet on the plate or ball in x direction will be equal to mass strike rate on the plate or ball. Mass strike rate on the plate or ball, this I will discuss afterward in some detail. Right now you just understand that m by t is mass strike rate on the plate. How it will be differ in different cases, I will just touch in after completing this. So m by t is equal to mass strike rate on the plate or ball into v1x is equal to, in which direction we want to find out the force applied by jet? X direction. So v1x is equal to initial velocity of the jet when jet is entering in the bowl or plate, minus v2 x is equal to final velocity of the jet when jet is leaving to the plate. So this equation always we give us the force applied by jet on the ball, plate, anything, turbine. So v1 x is, I have already told, that initial velocity of jet in x direction, that is during striking on the plate or ball, during initial velocity when just entering in the ball. V2x is called the final velocity of jet in x direction, that is when jet is leaving the jet, when jet is leaving, by mistake I have written twice, when jet is leaving the plate or ball after striking on it. So this by using that equation we can find out the force applied by jet on the plate. In any case, in any turbine, pump, only that equation will be help to you know the force on the turbine. Now I want to give some important note. When plate or ball is fixed with respect to jet, means plate or ball is stationary, there is no motion in the plate or ball, only jet is having motion. Obviously jet would have motion, without motion there is no meaning of jet. So in such case, the complete mass of the jet will strike on the ball when plate is stationary. So in such case we can find out the mass strike rate very simply. If cross section area of the jet orifice is A and velocity of coming out the liquid or water from the jet is V and rho is the density of the liquid, then we know that discharge will be A into V. Discharge will be A into V. Previously, in previous chapter, we already know from the knowledge of previous chapter that discharge will be A into V. Through any section, discharge will be cross section area into velocity of the flow. So AV will be discharge, and mass strike rate will be volume flow rate into density, because volume into density will be mass. So discharge into density will be mass flow rate, M by T. So Q will be A into V rho. So A is the area of cross section area of the jet, V is the velocity of the jet coming out from nozzle, and rho is the density. So A rho V, rho A V, this give us the mass strike rate when plate is stationary. But when there is motion in plate also, then how will calculate the mass flow rate? If plate or ball is moving with respect to plate, then in equation 3, at the place of V, this is equation 3, in the place of V, the relative velocity of the jet with respect to plate will be introduced. So when plate will also move, then mass strike rate will be, this velocity will be relative velocity. So in place of V, we will have to write VR. What is the VR? Relative velocity of the jet with respect to plate. So this is the simple difference of mass strike rate. When plate is stationary, then simply we will have to take the velocity of jet. But when plate is also moving, then we will have to take the relative velocity of jet with respect to plate. This will give us the mass strike rate. Remember this, this is always mass strike rate. This is not the mass flow rate, this is the mass strike rate. Okay. So as I told that when the plate is also moving, then in place of V, we will have to write the relative velocity of the jet with respect to plate, that is VR, for the moving plate or ball. Now, force applied by jet on the plate or ball. So as we have already calculated the force in basic concepts, the same thing I will mention here. Just I will write in the place of mass strike rate, rho av. So from all above discussion, we got that the force applied by jet on the ball or plate is in a particular direction. From all above discussion, we got that the force applied by jet on the ball or plate in a particular direction, say x direction, is given by the equation fx is equal to force applied by jet on the ball, mass strike rate on the plate or ball into initial velocity when jet is entering in the ball or plate, or minus final velocity when jet is leaving to the plate or ball. So mass strike rate will be given by this equation rho a vr. Vr will be equal to velocity of jet when the plate is fixed. So I am giving a general equation. Mass strike rate is equal to rho av for stationary plate and rho avr for moving plate. This is the relative velocity of jet. So this is the equation of force. Mass strike rate means rho avr into v1x minus v2x. Now power supplied by jet to the plate or ball. Force we have calculated. Now we have to calculate the power supplied by jet to the plate or ball. That is the very important point. That is the calculation of work done. The concept of power calculation, power supplied by jet to the plate, give us the concept for calculating the work done by turbine or power of turbine. So this is the very important thing we need to understand, we need to focus here. So power supplied by jet to the plate, as we know that from mechanics, we have studied mechanics, but in mechanics we have not studied the dynamic part. So but in physics you would have already studied that if a body is moving with velocity v and in the direction of velocity, if F force is being applied on the body, then what will be power of the body, work done per second by the body? Force into velocity. That we know very well from mechanics, concept of mechanics. So power supplied by jet, this I want to calculate, but first I want to brief you concept of power. As we know that, as we know very well from the mechanics, that if a body is moving with a constant velocity vx and a force is fx, let me flip the page, is being applied on the plate in the direction of motion, then the power of the body will be given by, I am mentioning here in the bracket, let vx and fx be in x direction, then power of the body will be given by p is equal to fx into vx. So power can be calculated only by multiplying by the velocity, force in the direction of velocity. This you need to understand. How can we calculate the power of a body? Body is having a some particular direction of motion. Suppose Vx is the direction of motion of a body. Then in direction of motion, what will be component of force? Body is moving in x direction. Suppose Vx is the force motion of the body in x direction. And in x direction, what is the component of force? That we will have to multiply by this Vx. Then we will get the power of the body, work done per second by the body, joule per second, watt. This is a very important concept for power calculation. So let us come on that. Refer the first page. Let the ball shown in the figure 1, in first page when we had started this chapter, you refer that figure, figure 1. Let the ball shown in the figure 1 is moving with the constant velocity ux in x direction, x plus direction. force on the ball will be given by equation 5 in x direction. That is the fx into fx. Refer the equation 5. So the power of the ball or power supplied, power of the ball will be power of, so the power of the ball or power supplied by the jet to the ball will be given by this equation. We want to calculate the power of the ball. What is the power of the ball? Force on the ball is fx. That is the force applied by jet on the ball, fx. And ux is the motion, direction of motion of the ball. So with the direction of motion of ball, we will multiply the force applied by jet on the ball. This is the force on the ball in same direction. So fx into ux, this gives us the power supplied by jet on the ball or plate. Or you may say that the power of the ball or power supplied by jet to the ball will be fx into u. P is equal to fx, will, what will be fx? Mass strike rate into v1x minus v2x into ux. And what will be mass strike rate? Rho a vr. And v1x minus v2x into ux. So this is the final equation to calculate the work done by the turbine. This equation will give you the work done by the turbine. And what, how can we write here this inwards? This is the mass strike rate. To mass strike rate of the jet on the plate or ball. V1x is the initial velocity of the jet when jet is entering in the ball or plate, minus V2x is the final velocity of jet when jet is leaving to the plate, into ux. Ux is the velocity of the ball or plate. So this is the equation, very important equation, and we need to understand the meaning of all the terms. Or you have already understood the meaning of all the terms, just I am repeating it again and again to make it very pakka in your mind. So this I have written this here. So this is the concept of calculating the power. So rest of thing we will see in next class. In this class we have seen the what is the basic concept behind the calculation of force applied by jet on the plate or ball, and we have seen that how to calculate the power supplied by jet on the ball or plate that will convert in turbine afterward. If number of ball or plate we will take in a circular thing, then that will call turbine. So but today we have developed the concept for calculating the force and power applied by jet on the plate or turbine. So let us stop today here. In next class we will see some different shapes of ball and plate, and how we will calculate the force and how we will calculate the power supplied by jet on the plate or ball. So different shapes we will take to make our concept more clear for calculating the power and calculating the force applied by jet on the plate or ball. So let us stop here. Thank you.